My friend didn't come visit me this month.
What you talking about? Pam comes by here damn near every day, barking and scratching at the door and whatnot. What you talking about?
Morgan!
All right. I told Tommy. But I damn sure didn't tell Uncle Pam.
Gina, how are you gonna have a baby when you still taking care of one?
Now, how you gonna get all up in my face with your breath smelling like 10-year-old cabbage? Huh? Don't you preserve that? I said, don't you preserve that?
Just get it.
You see, that kind of thing affects the baby.
Oh, God, well, that explains it then. I guess when your mother was pregnant with you, she was watching The Incredible Shrinking Man.
You worked on that. And I guess when your mama had you, she must have been watching The Adventures of Ren 10-10.
I'll save you.
Stupid. What?
You carry a home pregnancy test in your purse?
Well, you never know when you might need one. I mean, when a friend might need one.
Oh. Thanks a lot, Pam.
Here you go.
You all out of tests?
Oh, yeah. Soon as they come in, some girl buys them all up.
Wait a minute. Face look like a big toe? Teeth look like the yellow brick road?
That's Pam.
You all out of tests?
Oh, yeah. Soon as they come in, some girl buys them all up.
Wait a minute. Face look like a big toe? Teeth look like the yellow brick road?
That's Pam.
You won? Yeah. Don't tell me. You won the limbo contest because you was the only one that can fit under the 1-inch bar, right?
Watch her, baby. Should have known it was you, Pam. Baby, when wild dogs foam at the mouth, that generally mean they got rabies. See the spackle right around her mouth? And we playing this afternoon. And Pam, we want you on the bench with us. Can you do that? Can you make that?
And why is that, Shorty Pippin?
So we can sit on your furry coat and not get splinters.
You know what? I don't have to take this. Get out of my way. Gina, I check you tonight.
Later, Pam.
Wait, Pam, don't go yet.
What?
Well, you want to leave without saying bye. And you know I like to kick you out my damn self. Hold on. Step. Step.
Cole's pacer broke down again. We got to go meet him.
Wait a minute. How is he going to get there? On his airplane?
Oh, it's you, Pam.
It's me.
I didn't recognize you without your feed bag.
Today is a very important day for me.
Yeah, one of them days. You come here often?
Mm-mm, Martin. You sitting at the wrong table, honey. We're sitting all the way over there.
Well, Pam, not anymore, all right? We're over here now, so you tell Gina and I'm gonna come over here, because I ain't moving no more tonight.
Ow.
Yeah, one of them days. You come here often?
Mm-mm, Martin. You sitting at the wrong table, honey. We're sitting all the way over there.
Well, Pam, not anymore, all right? We're over here now, so you tell Gina and I'm gonna come over here, because I ain't moving no more tonight.
Girl,
yeah. See, now you fighting dirty. You didn't have to bring a van to Uglyfield into this.
Just get out of my way.
Go on about your business for somebody to get hurt.
You better get out of my way.
Okay, you in my place. I ain't got to step nowhere. All right, I ain't gonna argue with y'all because there's two of y'all. Y'all want to call in the cops and I'm in trouble.
That's right. You forget something, Billy Flea Williams?
Yeah, I forgot how bad my place smells after you've been in it.
You know what, Gina? If I were you, I would get rid of this G.I. joke. A and get me a full-size man?
Get out of my face. It's not the time. Step.
All right.
Okay? Planning to run off to the Bahamas with all my money, Jim.
With all your money, man? Broke as you are, they not gonna run very far.
I wasn't even talking to you, Janet, jackass.
You run that street.
Planning to run off to the Bahamas with all my money, Jim.
With all your money, man? Broke as you are, they not gonna run very far.
I wasn't even talking to you, Janet, jackass.
You run that street. Get right
here.
Come on.
Martin, I didn't play this well. Well, I'm glad to see that Baldy, Moe, and Whack finally got the dish fixed in time for the fight.
Even you can't bother me, Muhammad Ugly.
Crazy. And who are you supposed to be, little tyke Turner?
And yourself?
I'm a cowgirl.
Oh, you're a cowgirl. Oh.
Right.
Well, at least you got the cow part right. How do- have a big announcement to make.
No, don't tell me. Don't tell me. Congratulations, little Tykey. You bought a new playpen.
No, Aretha Stanklin. Gina and I brought a new house.
Wait a minute, Martin. Mm. I know you can fit into Bobby's dream house, but what about Gina? I mean, the little car, the minivan, how's she gonna fit? That's just selfish.
That's all right. Because the only house you go own...
What?
Gonna say Rex on it. Rex don't live here anymore.
You know, you don't have to...
I say Rex don't live here. I say Rex don't live here.
Answer the phone.
Y'all can come, all right?
See?
But hey, you just make sure you bring some newspaper.
For what?
Because you're not housebroken yet. Okay?
I don't like the way that man in that picture is staring at me. He's giving me the creeps.
You ever stop to think what you're doing to him, Pam?
Martin.
Did she ever
stop?
Hey, he could be hibernating.
Hey, Pam, are you bears hibernating yet? I mean, is it that
time
of season?
Leave me alone. Yeah,
yeah, don't go ahead and jump.
Leave me.
Y'all go ahead,
Gina, too.
Oh, my God. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Wait a minute. This is all your fault. The reason why this house is so cheap, because it's haunted.
That's because you're here, Scarando. Gina, too.
Oh, my God. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Wait a minute. This is all your fault. The reason why this house is so cheap, because it's haunted.
That's because you're here, Scarando. What's up, Pat?
What's up? What you think of our uniforms?
Who you trying out for? The New York Stankies?
Why don't you go bungee jump off a curb, Shortland Trailblazer?
All right, just say.
That's cool and all, but all I want to know is how are you and Pam Cassell going to stop Marty Marr's All-Stars?
What you gonna do now, Runty Stiltskin?
Horse radish.
Don't forget the horse radish.
Horse? Why are you telling me, Gina? You can get the radish from the horse you're standing next to.
All right, this ain't no boxing match. Come on.
Horse radish.
Don't forget the horse radish.
Horse? Why are you telling me, Gina? You can get the radish from the horse you're standing next to.
All right, this ain't no boxing match. Come on.
Snap. I didn't even know they made teeny tiny shoes this size.
That's all right. Don't worry about that. I'm gonna have them bring you some horseshoes. Now, are you sure you want Gladys Fright and the Pips to be there?
Oh, yes, of course. Miss Fright and her pimps are more than welcome to come.
I have not seen this many zeros since your family reunion.
At least at our family reunion, we don't eat our young.
Okay, don't start. Not in front of my boss.
I give you Pam.
What?
If you let me keep the gifts. Look, she won't make much of a wife, but she'll guard your palace better than any pit bull I know.
Awesome.
And that's the boss. I'm giving you a boss.
Hey, what's up? Those are some fly skis, Gina. Those are nice.
No.
Anyway, what are you using for skis? Two popsicle sticks?
You just make sure when we get out there on the ski slopes, you keep your mouth shut. I don't want you melting the snow. Halitosis.
Hey, Martin, hey. If you need some earmuffs, I got a couple of throw rugs I could give you.
And I go around you. Next time, my brother, read the signs. When you feed bears, they follow you home. I don't care how much porridge you give her, you ain't never getting rid of her. She ain't going nowhere. No slope. I'm staying right here in the lodge, getting my chill on.
What's the matter, little man? You scared?
Only of your face.
Y'all come to dinner. Dinner's ready. Let's go.
Good, because I'm about as hungry as a Pam. Okay, everybody. Pam, would you like to bark a few words? Pam, would you like to bark a few words? You know, look at you living.
Martin, don't even try it. I don't know why you tripping. As tiny as this place is, you should feel right at home.
Yeah, well, you better be careful. I seen one of your little cousins in the corner.
All right, look at you.
Wait a minute. Bedroom? The only way you can sleep in there is standing up.
And why don't you show him how it's done, Mr. Ed? Wilbur!
Hey, wait!
Why you starting up in there, man? Why you trying to fight up in this place, though? Right. That's just disrespect.
Wait a minute. Bedroom? The only way you can sleep in there is standing up.
And why don't you show him how it's done, Mr. Ed? Wilbur!
Why you starting up in there, man? Why you trying to fight up in this place, though? Right. That's just disrespect.
Pam, what are you doing here? You look more scarier than usual.
I ain't Pam, little drummer boy. I'm the spirit of Christmas future.
Well, damn. They ain't got no cure for yuck mouth in the future?
Shut it up, Tiny Tim!
Give them a cheap gift.
Wait a minute, Martin. Where did you do your Christmas shopping? The 99 cent store?
Oh.
That was my Christmas jokey joke.
You know that's funny, right? You know
that's not hilarious. That funny.
It's hilarious. Merry Christmas to you, too. Your girl, I tell you.